So, Rupert, y'all take your darts over here pretty seriously, huh?
This and, what's the billiard game y'all do that sounds like a brand of cookies?
Snooker?
That's it. That's the one. Yeah, boy, I'd love to curl up on a couch under a weighted blanket, watch You've Got Mail, and devour a box of Snookers. Let's see what we got here. Hey, there it is.
Do you like darts, Ted?
Oh, they're okay. I'm more of a, you know, a cornhole man myself. Yeah. Nope.
Yeah. How about a game? I mean, we could, you know, maybe wager, say, £10,000.
Well, as my doctor told me when I got addicted to fettuccine Alfredo, that's a little rich for my blood. How about this? If you win, I'll let you pick the starting lineup of the last two games of the season. But if I win, you can't go anywhere near the owner's box, at least not while Rebecca's still in charge.
Ted, what the hell are you doing?
Well, I believe some folks call it white knighting, but I don't know. I'm just following my gut here. It's okay. Ted. It's okay. What do you think?
You're on.
Okay.
Double in, double out.
Whatever you say, Rupert Dupes. Yeah, just let me know if I'm winning or losing, all right?
Oh, I forgot I had these on me.
Oh, yeah. Oh, wait a second. I forgot I'm left-handed. Oh, it's going to be a hoot.
180!
William Rupert, get in!
Shut your stupid little twat mouth, or I will shut it for you.
May, what do I need to win?
Two triple 20s and a bullseye.
Good luck. You know, Rupert, guys have underestimated me my entire life. And for years, I never understood why. It used to really bother me. But then one day, I was driving my little boy to school, and I saw this quote by Walt Whitman. It was painted on the wall there. It said, "Be curious, not judgmental." And I like that. So I get back in my car, and I'm driving to work. And all of a sudden, it hits me. All them fellas that used to belittle me, not a single one of them were curious. You know, they thought they had everything all figured out, and so they judged everything, and they judged everyone. And I realized that they're underestimating me. Who I was had nothing to do with it. Because if they were curious, they would ask questions. You know? Questions like, "Have you played a lot of darts, Ted?" Which I would have answered, "Yes, sir." Every Sunday afternoon at a sports bar with my father from age 10 till I was 16 when he passed away. Barbecue sauce.